I'm just half an hour behind everyone else.
It's a riddle. Families can be just as complicated as a riddle, but with 25 million users signed up to the leading family tree website, it's clear people are really intrigued by their history. Genetics specialist Turi King and life coach Mavis, my mum, have advice for you before you start digging. Morning to you.
Nice to see you, Turi.
It's studying your family tree. It's fascinating, but it's now also easier. It's more popular than ever, isn't it, Turi?
We're in an absolute golden age. So you were saying earlier, so National Archives, they're just putting the 300,000 wartime farm records online. And this is one of a number of initiatives. So we've got parish records going online, this kind of thing. So, you know, in history, we tend to think like the big names and the kings and the queens and this kind of thing. But these records going online means that we get like a glimpse into the life of our ancestors and all the little stories that are in there. You can do this all from your living room. I love it. I just think it's amazing. Yeah.
That's the thing. I think before it had been incredibly overwhelming to even think about where to start. It is more accessible now than ever. Where do you start with your searches?
Okay, so if you want to go online, there's free websites, so like free BMD. If you want to start going a little bit deeper, you are probably going to have to go for the big ones like Ancestry, Find My Past, and that's going to cost you money. But it does give you access to various databases all at once, which is fantastic. The other thing I would suggest is that if you do want to like order a birth certificate or a marriage certificate, don't necessarily go through those websites. Go to the General Register Office because it tends to be cheaper. Get to know your local record office, so they can be fantastic. So, for example, I had to do a case recently where I wanted to know who lived at a particular address. And so I rang up the record office, and they were lovely. They did it for free for me. They will do research for you, which is great. And then the other thing is go for family history groups online, Facebook. There's loads of people out there with social media who will help you with your family tree.
So yes, lots social media is helpful now,
isn't
it? Yeah, for
a
the
really
positive.
Useful tool. And Mum, what would you say to someone though before they start exploring? Because the whole process could be quite daunting.
Well, it is, isn't it? It is a daunting experience, and you're probably going to, you know, experience a whole host of emotions. You may find something, excuse me, and you may not, and that might be disappointing. So it's in, you know, it's about preparing yourself, you know, for that journey. And remember, it's your journey. Somebody may have done it that you know, and they had a completely different experience. They may have found, you know, that they were related, I don't know, to you, Geffen. And they thought, wow,
that'd be a turnip, wouldn't it?
You could actually be related to somebody famous. That probably not going to be the case in most cases. And so it is important to set yourself out and prepare yourself as you would for any journey. And as a life coach, I would be concerned about you doing it in a cautious and considered way. So I've got four questions that I think you should all, if you're going to start on that journey, is to ask yourself before you start that journey. And so the first question would be, what has actually inspired you to actually want to look into your family tree? Was it something somebody else has done and you said, oh, I think I'd like to do that? You found out a lot of information. Don't necessarily do it for that reason. Think long and hard before you do that. And write down the reasons why you want to do it, because when you write something down, it's concrete, it's in your mind. And throughout these questions, write answers down to them, because that way you'll be able to plan your journey if you do decide to do it. The second question: when do you feel it's the right time for you to start this journey? It's your journey, remember. So it's got to be your timing. Things may be going on in your life. Consider those things. Put down what is happening in your life now and then think, maybe it's not a good time now, or yes, I've got lots of time and I'm feeling good. That brings me on to the third question. Are you in the right state of mind to take this on, mentally, physically, and emotionally? Because you will find out a whole host of information. Hopefully, you may be able to deal with it, you may not. If you're not in a good state of mind yourself, maybe this isn't a good time for you to start. So consider that and write down how you feel about it when you're doing these few questions. Also, basically, the last one, where would you like to find your research, where you're going to start to look for that? And as Turi mentioned, there are various places. It is so easy to find out lots of information nowadays, isn't it? Like DNA testing and things like that. And sometimes you'll find out a whole host of things, and sometimes you might find out something that you really didn't want to know, or it could be quite emotional. So it is important to discuss with your loved ones about what you're thinking of doing, because they might have a secret and they're thinking, goodness me, they might find out about that. Mm. You never know.
No.
It may be an absolutely fantastic journey, and hopefully it is, but do your prep. I would always say plan, time it, and prepare, prepare, prepare.
Absolutely. And to back that up as well, if you're going to do DNA testing, I mean, we know from DNA Family Secrets that sometimes you can find out things that you really were not expecting to find. Sometimes they can be absolutely wonderful. They can often be incredibly emotional. So what Mavis is saying here about, you know, be prepared, understand that this will be an emotional journey, potentially, not just for you, but for your family members, but also, say you find a half-sibling for their families.
Yeah.
So bear all of this in mind, and it's about respect and kindness, I think.
You've delved into your ancestry, haven't you? Did it help with, I don't know, identity, learning about yourself?
I think when you are mixed race, and, you know, Michelle will have her slant on it, you do sort of, well, not suffer, but you are challenged with your identity. And being brought up by an English parent and a Ghanaian parent, you know, I was always connected to the UK and my English or, you know, heritage here. And through my father, you know, he's passed now, unfortunately, there's my dad and Michelle that was on a graduation day. And that is the cloth that we wear in the Gar tribe. Very proud of that picture. It's about me sort of staying connected to my father. And what I did find out when I did look into my father's history and I did go back to Ghana was that quite a few family members are in the media. I've got an actor, we've got a radio, TV presenters, very creative, and we like the art. So you do think, is that in our DNA? I mean, you'd probably be able to tell me, Turi. And that was a big thing. Also, a big thing in my father's family is his brother is a chief of the Gar tribe. And the chief's roles are like sort of, you know, the dignitaries, and they've got very official roles, but also they are good listeners and they sort of help people move forward in their lives. And that's always been inherent with me. If anybody wants to find out or help with life, I've always been that person.
I've always said you're one of the best listeners I think I've ever
really
met. Yeah, you take it all in, doesn't miss a bit, actually. And runs in the family.
There we go. Yeah. But it is interesting, isn't it, when you start to delve a bit deeper and find those connections, and it does make you question your identity and where things come from. It is really interesting.
Any other tips that we need to know about if we're going to look into the past of a family?
I always tell people, talk to family. So exactly what you have been saying. Go and talk to any older family members. Go and have a look at photographs. And goodness, you just hope that on the back they've been writing names as to who's on the photo, things like that. I was given my grandma's old Bible, and in the front was, you know, names, dates, marriages, that kind of thing. That's what you want. So you want your names, you want your dates, you want your locations and relationships. Those are the things you're looking for when you're building your family tree.
Amazing.
So interesting.
It is so fascinating.
It really is.